Good morning, boys and girls, and welcome to White Pine District Library's Story Hour. Today we're going to talk about something very special. Something that starts out as one thing and turns into another, and then another, and then another. Right now, I'm sure you've seen several of these things. They look like my friend. They are called butterflies. And butterflies have a life cycle where they change into four different things. Now, our story today talks about the butterfly. One time in a garden, in a flower bed, there was a plant. Now, some people call that plant a weed, and some people call it a beautiful wildflower. And the name of that plant was a milkweed. And a butterfly, just like mine, a monarch, because a monarch is orange and white, saw that milkweed and decided that would be a beautiful home for her babies. So she laid her eggs on the underside of the weed. And those eggs were small and white. And they sat there, and they sat there. The butterfly didn't stay around to take care of them like moms and dads take care of children. She flew away. And those eggs stayed there all by themselves until they were ready to hatch. And those little white eggs opened up, and out crawled a very small caterpillar. Now, the caterpillars of the monarch butterfly have a lot of color. They're not fuzzy, but they have a lot of color. They have black. They have white, and they have yellow, and it's striped. And they start out very, very small because they were in that very, very small egg. And that little caterpillar emerged from that egg, and he looked around into this big world that he had arrived in, and went, wow, what is this place? Because he could see beautiful blue sky, and fluffy clouds, and he could hear birds, and he could see different green grasses and other flowers that were pink and purple and maybe even blue. But the plant he was on was just green, and he decided that his tummy was hungry, and so he crawled onto that top of the leaf, and he decided that he would chew. And he chewed, and he chewed, and he grew, and he grew, and he chewed, and he chewed, and he grew and grew some more. And pretty soon, that teeny tiny caterpillar was much, much larger. And he continued to eat, and he got bigger, and he decided that he was very, very tired. So he found a nice, shady spot. And even though he felt tired, he had a job to do. So he crawled up underneath that leaf, and he spun, and he spun, and he made a chrysalis. Now, a chrysalis is like a little package all wrapped up, and that little caterpillar was the present inside. He was inside that package. Sometimes on the outsides of the chrysalis, depending upon what type of butterfly it is, they have little gold dots or little gold lines. That's what the monarchs look like. And they're very beautiful. They're a very light green, and they have those little golden spots on it. And that little caterpillar, now bigger, stayed inside that cocoon or chrysalis, and he changed. He changed from a caterpillar to butterfly. And he stayed in there and he stayed in there. Monarch butterfly needs at least 11 days to become a butterfly. So he stayed inside that chrysalis. And hopefully the birds couldn't find him, or other creatures that might find that chrysalis interesting and maybe even tasty. So he stayed in there safe and hidden in his spot underneath the leaf. And pretty soon he felt his body changing and he needed more room. He needed to spread out. He just was too tight in there. And all of a sudden that chrysalis burst open. And out came a butterfly. He was no longer a caterpillar. He was a beautiful butterfly with lovely wings. Now those wings were hugging tight to his body, and he couldn't fly yet because they were kind of wet. And so he crawled on top of that leaf, and he kind of sat there in the sun with his wings out, trying to dry them out. He let them go up and down and up and down, and that got the air moving around him, and those wings soon dried. Now that little caterpillar was ready to explore that great big world that he had seen. That blue sky with the clouds, the trees over there, the flowers over there. He was ready to explore. So he spread his wings wide, and he started to move them, and he leaped, and he began to fly. And he flew carefully through the air and beautifully, and as he flew, it became easier and easier, and it was beautiful. He got to visit this flower and that flower, and he was thirsty, so he drank from those flowers. He found a raindrop or a drop of water on a rock, and he drank that. He had a lovely world, and he could just float around and enjoy it as much as he wanted. Now, that little butterfly, who used to be our little tiny egg, had to prepare for a very long trip, because monarch butterflies fly very long ways to spend their winters, because it's too cold here and it's getting chilly, and those butterflies are going to get ready to fly. They're going to go south, and when they go south, they get in groups, and they fly in groups, and they look like clouds of butterflies, and they fly clear down into Mexico, where they stay for the winter. Now, our little butterfly had made a lot of changes in his life. Now he's a butterfly, but he used to be a caterpillar, a big caterpillar that made a chrysalis and rested for a while to turn into a butterfly. And then one time he was a teeny tiny caterpillar. And before that, he was a teeny tiny egg. Now his job would be to fly to Mexico, stay there while it's cold here in Michigan, and then he will fly back north, and he will do the same thing that the butterfly did earlier, and that is to lay eggs, so that other butterflies would come. Now, that butterfly's life sounds wonderful. And I think he was very happy. Now, our butterfly here looks kind of like a monarch. She has the same colors, orange and black and the little white dot. So maybe she is a type of butterfly. But I also brought in an example of a real butterfly, a monarch, like the one in our story. And unfortunately, This butterfly is no longer with us. It ran into a car, and the car is bigger than a butterfly, and the butterfly can't win against a car. So I have him here so I can show you, and let's see what he looks like. Can you see him there in my jar? That's a monarch butterfly. He looks a lot like this butterfly, doesn't he? He has the polka dots that are white along the edge of his wings. He has the fields of orange there in the middle. The only thing that's different is that butterfly has a black body and yours is yellow. So, a little different, but not a lot. But that's a real monarch. And I keep him in the jar just so I can show children like you. Should we try to catch the butterfly? Probably not, because their wings are so delicate. They're just like a paper thin. And if we damage their wings, they can no longer fly. And if they can't fly, they can't get food or water and they will die. So it's best if we just enjoy the butterflies by watching them. And let them do their flying and not touch them. Now, if you find one that's died like this one, it's okay to pick them up. But don't touch them when they're alive, okay? Now, in our hands, if you think about it, we can make the items or the things that the butterfly was before it became a butterfly. So if you take your hands and you squinch them all together, stick your thumb up, and cover up that thumb, you have an egg. Look at there. Looks like a butterfly egg. And it stays like that on the leaf for a while. And pretty soon, something wiggles in there. Wiggle your hands. Wiggle your hands. What? Oh my goodness. Look at there. Maybe that thumb is like a caterpillar. That caterpillar. He's going to scooch around and move around. That's our caterpillar. Now when our caterpillar gets big, fat like my thumb, he's going to make a chrysalis. So let's put that caterpillar inside the chrysalis. And he's going to stay in that chrysalis. He's going to stay in there until he gets too big and he has to come out because he's outgrown that space. So we're going to open our hands. And guess what? Out comes a butterfly. See his antenna? And here's his wings. So you can make a butterfly with your hand. So we have the caterpillar that goes in the egg, or is in the egg, and then comes out as a caterpillar. And then he goes in the chrysalis. Maybe we have two. We have them in the chrysalis. And they start to grow, and they get too big for that chrysalis, and then they make a butterfly. So can you make a butterfly with your hands? Can you make it fly? Can you make it fly? Now, I showed you the real butterfly. You're probably getting a little bit of a glare. But if you find one that's been killed by a car, or maybe it just got old and died, and that happens too, then you can bring out your magnifying glass and you can look at the butterfly up close. Maybe you can see some of those things a little closer. Let's see if you can see the head or the body. See that? So if you use a magnifying glass, then you can look at things more closely. Another way to look at butterflies and see how they live is to get on the computer. If you get on the computer and you type in the life cycle of a butterfly, I'm sure that Google will have something for you to watch. You can watch the entire process of a butterfly becoming a butterfly. The caterpillar, the chrysalis, and then the butterfly. There are a lot of cool videos about butterflies out there that you can watch. You can also get on there and look up different kinds of butterflies. Now, I have a book that has some butterflies in it. And let's see if we can look at them. This page says the traveling insects. And right there, if you look, let's see if I can get this closer. If you look, see this right here? This is a tree in Mexico, and those are all monarch butterflies. Isn't that beautiful? They cling to the branches of trees down there, and they look like a butterfly tree. But there are different kinds. Look at over here, we have another kind. This one is orange and black and white as well, but it's a different kind. Let's look over here. This one's called a swallowtail because of those different little shapes on the bottom of their wings. We have swallowtails here in Michigan. Generally, we see the eastern swallowtail, and they are yellow and black. And they have that little flashy nib on the bottom of their wing. But there are all kinds of butterflies. This book shows you where they live in the world. Butterflies are found all over the world. Different kinds, different colors, different sizes. Some are teeny tiny. We have a blue one that comes through. They don't always stay here, but they visit us in Michigan in the beginning of the summer. They're only about that big, and they're blue. They're beautiful. There's a little orange one, and he's not very big either. But here is a monarch butterfly in this book. And here he is on that milkweed like we talked about in the story. Monarchs prefer milkweed for their food source. So I try not to pick the milkweed. I let it grow. And see this pod right here? Right now they're making seeds, and if we let them grow and let them sprinkle all over our yard, more milkweeds will grow. And that will provide the monarch butterfly with a place to lay their eggs and provide their young with food and a place to grow up. This here is the eastern swallowtail. This one here is the red admiral. So there are all kinds of butterflies. And there are all kinds of books that you can get that have butterflies in them. Now, there's a good story in the library that you could read that talks about the very thing we talked about in our story today. It's called A Very Hungry Caterpillar by Eric Carle. It's a very good story, but it talks about that little caterpillar and how hungry he was and the magic that happened later. So that might be a story that you would like to borrow from the library. It's a good story. Now, we also have activity bags for you. If you would like to get one, you can call the library, or you can email us here at the library, or you can just stop in and pick one up. But there are things in there for you to do. Some of the items in there are, oh, let's see. We have a bookmark for your book that talks about the different stages of the butterfly and what happens. So we have the butterfly and laying an egg, becoming a caterpillar, getting fat and becoming that big caterpillar, and then becoming the chrysalis. And then the chrysalis is ready to open, and then that butterfly. So there's something there for you too. You're going to find in your bag some paper strips so you can make a caterpillar. Now, you're going to have a piece of pipe cleaner, I had to think for a minute, that you can make antenna with. And you've got paper strips that you make a circle. And then you can either tape it or glue it. And then you take another strip of paper and you thread it through there. And see if it cooperates. Then you make another circle. So now I've got two circles. And then you can add another ring. And pretty soon, you will have a caterpillar. And then the antenna go on his head, whichever color you would like his head to be. So you can make the caterpillar. There is a baggie with some items to make and decorate this butterfly. There is, oh my, let's see. There's some alphabet work. There's some dot-to-dot work. There's some work that you can practice cutting. And these are the different life cycles of the butterfly. And you can match them up. And maybe moms and dads or grandpas and grandmas can help you figure out which one goes where. Just pick one to be number one, and then you go around the circle, okay? So there's a couple things like that. And then you can do your own craft with the life cycle of the butterfly. You've got a paper plate, and the sections have been numbered 1, 2, and 3. So you also have some leaves to cut out, and you can glue those on your paper plate. And once you get your leaves glued on there, you can open up this little baggie that goes with it, and you're gonna find, you're gonna say, that's like for macaroni and cheese. Well, this is for our butterfly. Yes, you could eat it for macaroni and cheese. You don't wanna eat it raw, it doesn't taste very good. But inside this baggie, you're going to find, there's a couple of beans that can be your butterfly's eggs. There are some twisted macaroni that can be your caterpillar. And then there are some shell macaroni to make your chrysalis. I don't know if you can see that. The light wants to shine through it. That can be your chrysalis. And then look at here. The bow tie makes a butterfly. So you can do that on your plate. And which one do you think comes first? And then what comes after that? And what comes after that? And what comes after that? So you have that project to do. And remember we talked about the hungry little caterpillar? In this bag, you can make your own hungry caterpillar, and there's some things in there for him to eat. So if you know the story about the hungry caterpillar, you can retell it by using the things in this bag. Now, we are going to have story hour every week on Tuesdays, okay? So look for story hour on the computer on Tuesdays, and we will tell stories and hopefully have some fun things for you to do and see. Now today we talked about the butterfly, and we talked about the egg and how the caterpillar wiggled out and became a caterpillar, and then he crawled inside the chrysalis and he made the chrysalis, and he got too big for the chrysalis. And then he made himself into a butterfly. So you're going to do that with the macaroni. You're going to be able to do that with the paper and the different sheets that you have. Hopefully you will learn a lot about the caterpillars and the butterflies that they become. So I hope you enjoyed Story Hour today. And I hope to see you next week. Come in and see us. You may not be able to play, but you can come in and check out some books. And maybe you can find a few that are about butterflies and caterpillars. And maybe you can read that Hungry Caterpillar. That would be a good story to read. So you guys have a nice day. Get outside and play. Look for those caterpillars. Look for those butterflies. See where they go. What kind of flower do they land on? Is it pink? Is it yellow? Or do you see them flying south? Maybe they're getting ready to head to Mexico. Who knows? But enjoy watching those butterflies. But just remember, don't touch them. Just watch them with our eyes. You just watch them with our eyes. We don't touch them. When we're watching them, we hold our hands like this and keep them that way, and just let the butterfly be. He'll be happier if we leave him alone, and you will too, because if you hurt him, you would feel sad. So we watch with our eyes and keep our hands still and closed so we don't touch them. We just enjoy them and watch them, okay? Well, you have a nice day. We hope to see you here at the library. We hope to hear from you, and we hope you have a lot of fun with the activity bags, and we'll see you next week when I think we're going to talk about creepy crawlers, maybe bugs. We'll see you then. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.